Hello everyone, I am Dr. Rajesh Singh from Department of Geology, University of Lucknow. In this lecture, I am going to demonstrate the clinographic projection of the zircon which is belonging to the tetragonal system. Okay. In tetragonal system, the A1 and A2 may have same length, but A3 axis will either longer or shorter. So axis ratio here change. In isometric system, all axis have ratio 1:1:1, 1:1:1, but here 1:1:0.9, considering the C axis as the shorter one. For clinographic projection, the ratio used again 1:2.7, ratio to 4. Some addition in C axis, that is 1 inch. So this model, that is zircon, is made up of two type of form. First is prism. These are the vertical prisms. There are four vertical prisms. Okay, the common Miller indices for these prism are mostly open form. Okay, these are not closed. These are the open forms, and the generally the Miller indices of the these prism are H00 or HH0. So for this projection, I am going to use will show the prism of HH0, and likewise these are the four pyramids up and down. These are the bipyramids. So bipyramids are the closed form. Prism are the open forms. Okay, these prism are the bipyramid. This is the prism. These are the vertical prism. Okay, these prism either intercept two axes at equal length and parallel to third one, or intercept one axis and parallel to two. For clinographic projection, I am going to demonstrate the prism which will intercept two axes and parallel to the third one. Likewise, these are the pyramids. These are the bipyramids. The bipyramids consist of the 8 faces. Okay, and it is closed form, whereas prism are the open forms. And likewise, the this prism pyramids are also have the Miller indices. General symbol is HHH or Miller, okay, and Miller indices is 1:1:1. Okay, regarding the symmetry element, so along this axis, that is the C axis, you will get the fourfold symmetry. Okay, and if you hold like this, rotate, you will get two. Either hold like this, you will get the two. Likewise, either hold like this, you will get two. So two are the diagonal axis, two are the axial crystallographic axis along the, you will get two fold symmetry, and one is four fold. So total axis of symmetry is how many? 5. Now regarding the plane of symmetry, make the plane along mirror planes along the corner points. These edges, the crystallographic edges, considering this. So you will get two mirror planes. Then mid of the faces, then you will get the two mirror planes, that is 4, and one mirror plane along this. Okay, so total mirror planes are also 5. So this will show 5 axis of symmetry, in which one axis, C axis, is showing the fourfold symmetry, other two diagonal and two crystallographic axis will show the twofold symmetry, and mirror planes are also 5. One mirror plane perpendicular to the C axis, and four mirror plane along the two along the crystallographic axis, and two along the diagonal axis. Center of symmetry is present. Typical mineral is zircon. So I think you know how to draw, determine the midpoint of the any line. For that, I am going to demonstrate using the isometric system axis. Okay. So take compass, mark the arc both side of the line. If considering this line, I am going to determine the midpoint of these lines. Mark the arc in both side. Okay. Mark the line. This line will divide this portion of the line into two halves. This is the midpoint. Okay. And this line is called as the bisector of the lines. So now I am going to draw the crystallographic projection of the this zircon. If you want to make such kind of the 3D model of the crystal, you can visit my channel and you will get there a video regarding this part one, that is making of the 3D models using cardboard. And who do not know how to draw the axis of the cubic system, also there is video available. So first I will draw the axis of the cubic system. Okay. Now name it ABCDEF. Likewise, in all isometric system models I have used same nomenclature. Now add up 1 inch in at end of E and end of F. So C axis will be become some longer in comparison to the C A2 axis and A3 axis. A2 axis and A1 axis. So add both side 1 inch. So unname it as double E and double F. Now draw the octahedron, but only four means top and bottom from the joining end of the edges of A1 or A2 with the positive end and A1 A2 with the negative end of the isometric axis, not this tetragonal axis. So for that, you have to join EC, ED, EB and BE, that is the back end. Likewise for the bottom also, FD, FC, BF and FA. In next step, we have to draw on the edge of this ABCD, the parallel lines. This line will be parallel to the A3. So draw the line from EB, C and D, which is parallel to the this A3 axis. So this line is parallel to the A3 axis, passing through the positive end of the A2. So likewise, this is the passing through the negative end of the A2 and parallel to the E3. This one is passing through the positive end of the A1 and parallel to the A3. And lastly, this is the back passing through the negative end of the A1. This is shown in dotted line because it is the back end face. This will give the back end face. So it is a marking dotted line, and all are the construction lines, remember. So do not mark any dark line. Okay. So next step, draw the four lines which is parallel to the either EC, either EB, either AE, either ED, passing through the AE. So draw these. Okay. Now do the same thing for the below one. So we will get how many? 8 intersection points. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Likewise, here also 1, 2, 3 and 4. Name it. So starting from here, only for the front faces, G, H, I, J, K, L, bike faces are M and N, intersection points. Okay, these are the, so these 8 intersection points are very important. Okay, now draw the outer lines. Now you can use the dark and thick lines, but not too much thick, but a little bit dark in comparison to the this construction line. So this is the front of the prism, front of the prism. Okay, each face will cut what, 2 crystallographic axes, you can see. Now draw the top. This is the front top. Now this is the bottom one, front and bottom. So likewise, you will get the bike faces. Now this model has been completed. Zircon is, you have drawn the zircon. You can count 4 prism, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 2 front prism and 2 bike. Likewise, this the top portion of the pyramid, that is 1, 2 front and 1, 2 is bike. Likewise, 1, 2 front and 1, 2 is bike. All 4 faces are visible here, and all are cutting at equal distance. At equal distance, these are the, you can draw the axis here. You will get the this cutting A1 axis, A2 negative, A1 positive and A3 negative. So this will have Miller indices. What, one positive one, that is 1, negative, negative means 1, 1 bar 1. Now this one will be have 1, 1, 1 bar. This one will have 1 bar 1, 1 bar, and this last bike face, the dark green, this field face have bar 1, bar 1, bar 1. Now draw the prism. So this is 4 prism. So this prism will have positive A1, positive A2 and parallel to the A3. So 1, 1, 0. This will 1, 0, 1, 1 bar 0. This will have bike 1, that is bar 1, bar 1, 0, and this will have bar 1, 1, 0. So now top pyramid, this will have 1, 1, 1. All 3 are positive. This will have 1, 1 bar 1. This face will have 1 bar 1, 1, and this will have 1 bar 1, bar 1. So this is the zircon. The beautiful zircon. Thank you.